Expenditure on eligible projects. Expenditure for promoting social and economic welfare or upliftment of the public. Section 35 AC. Now, before I go and read the section, let me tell you that for Section 35 AC, SSEs are classified into two categories. One is the corporate SSE and the other one is the non-corporate SSE. Right? A corporate SSE, for the purpose of this expenditure, can incur the expenditure in-house, meaning he can themselves incur some expenditure for upliftment of the public, or it can contribute it to the agencies which are nominated for this purpose. A non-corporate SSE, on the other hand, can only contribute. They cannot incur in-house expenditure. And even if they do, they are not eligible for deduction under this section. Right? Company may incur in-house expenditure or make contribution to other companies. Non-corporate SSE can only contribute to third parties. Right? Just knock this off, please. Third thing. Payment made to a public sector company or a local authority or an association or institution approved by the National Committee for carrying out any eligible project or scheme. So there is this committee called the National Committee, which is going to nominate various eligible projects. Okay. Then there are public sector companies or local authorities or associations or institutions who will carry out these projects. Okay, and if the company or the non-corporate SSE makes a contribution to these, then it is available as a deduction. Right? The thing is that if you are contributing, the sum should actually have been paid, or if you are doing it in-house in case of companies, then the expenditure should have been actually incurred to claim a deduction. An additional compliance is that to claim this deduction, you have to furnish the following along with his return of income. So if you make a contribution to a third party, a certificate in form 58A from the recipient has to be submitted. Whereas if you incur in-house expenditure by the company, a CA certificate has to be obtained. Now in some cases what can happen is, let's say this is the SSE. He makes a payment to a public sector company, okay, or other eligible person. But subsequently, this company is disentitled from the exemption. Irrespective of whether this is disentitled, if he makes a contribution and he gets this receipt in form 58A, okay, which was done before this company was disentitled, then the deduction is still available. Even where the recipients are disentitled from exemption subsequently, contribution made are still eligible for deduction. Right? Let's move on to the next one then.